Now let us continue with the next question from same May 2008. Okay, here in this question 3A is design the Turing machine for A raised to n, B raised to n, C raised to n, where n is greater than or equal to 1. If this question is really very important question, it has been asked many times in the university exam for 10 marks. Okay, so don't just miss out this question, this is really very important. But this question I have covered in one of my video titled Turing Machine Example Part 1. So you can just check my this video and you'll get the answer for the question. Okay, so I'll not solve it again over here. Let's just continue to the next question, that is question 3b. Write a right linear grammar and left linear grammar for this regular expression and show derivation tree for this string. Okay, let us first try to construct the right linear and left linear grammar. Let me tell you, this question at the first glance we can say that it is really very difficult, I know how to do this and I just want to leave this question, but there is one trick, and with that trick you will find it really very easy and you will always attempt this question, and this question has come for 10 marks, and if you know this it takes very less time, very less effort, and it gives you 10 marks, so don't miss out this question. Okay, now let us start with this. So that is, we have given a regular expression. Let me just write down the regular expression. 0 plus 1 closure followed by 0. I need to construct the right linear grammar. Let me just focus on right linear grammar. Do you all know that how do we write right linear grammar? It is a type of regular grammar. It is divided in two types, right linear and left linear. So regular grammar is of two types, right linear and left linear grammar. Okay? Right linear grammar has all the rules something like this. Okay, left linear grammar has the rules like this. Do you observe something? In right linear grammar, all the capital letter comes on the right side. In left linear grammar, capital letter comes on the left side. And we can have maximum one capital letter, minimum zero capital letters. Okay, and we will have one small letters in each of the production rule. This we call as a production rule. So this is all about the grammar, right linear grammar and left linear grammar. So this is three production rules, these are three production rules. Every grammar should have a S which is indicating a start symbol. So we will always start with S rule. Okay. So this is all about the basic introduction about right linear and left linear grammar. Let me just start with the explanation of this answer. So now we want to generate the right linear grammar for this regular expression. But can we just now focus on ye regular expression hai aur hum log ko iska DFA banana hai. So we will draw the diagram for this DFA. So what will be the diagram? Really it is very easy. You can say this is state A. Okay. On 0 and 1. It can have many combinations of 0 and 1 and then it will end with 0. That means it is some string which is ending with 0. Ending with 0 hai matlab 0 aayega to wo final state pe jayega. Barabar hai? 0 aayega to final. Before 0, 0 or 1 ke koi bhi combinations aa sakte hain. So before 0 I can have any combination of 0 and 1 coming, and then after that if I get 0 I'll go to the final state. So this is the DFA for this regular expression. Really very easy. Now with this DFA we will generate this right linear grammar. Before that hum log ko right linear grammar ka start state kya chahiye, S. So hum log isko initial state ka naam banayenge S, aur uske baad ABCD whatever we can give. So I'll just rename my states. Now I'll start writing the right linear grammar for this question. So right linear grammar over here is, I'll start with the first state, that is S, giving on 0 it goes to S. So I'll say on 0 it goes to S. The next production rule will be S on 1 goes to S. The next production rule will be S on 0 goes to capital A. So here I got three production rules, and I have for each production, each line or each symbol I have written one production rule each. And finally, which is the final state? A is the final state. So always you should be writing final state gives epsilon. That should be the extra rule which we need to add. So with this we are done with the right linear grammar. Now if you want to make the left linear grammar, we just need to reverse this DFA. How do we reverse this? Okay, let me just tell you. What we need to do is, जो final है उसका start बनाओ, जो start है उसको final बनाओ. So ये final बनेगा, ये start बनेगा. Start बनेगा तो इसका नाम S बनेगा. इसका नाम हम लोग कुछ भी डाल सकते हैं. So I'll just give it a name as A. Keep the symbols as it is, productions, but just reverse the direction of the production. So here this production direction will be reverse. This production reverse, ऐसे करो वैसे करो, it is all same because it is a self loop. The values will remain same as it is. And this is a start state. So do you understand how do we reverse this DFA? Now after reversing the DFA, we can now write down the left linear grammar. So how is the left linear grammar? We'll start with the start state. Now though it is a left linear grammar, the capital letter yahan pe right mein aaya tha, lekin yahan pe left mein aayega. So S on 0 goes to A. So S on 0 goes to A. ये कैपिटल लेटर मैंने लेफ्ट में लिखा है पर्पसफुली बिकॉज दिस इज अ लेफ्ट लीनियर ग्रामर. नेक्स्ट इज ए ऑन जीरो गोज टू ए. सो ए ऑन जीरो गोज टू ए. ए ऑन वन गोज टू ए. दैट इज ए ऑन वन गोज टू ए. नाउ व्हिच इज माय फाइनल स्टेट? ए. सो फाइनल स्टेट के लिए एक एक्स्ट्रा रूल लिखना है, दैट इज फाइनल स्टेट गिविंग एप्सिलॉन. ओके, so do we understood this particular answer? Really it is very easy to understand, and this is how we get the right linear and left linear grammar. Now looking at this, our first part is solved. Okay, the next part is show derivation tree for 1 0 1 0 1 1 0. Now we will draw the derivation tree for this both right linear and left linear grammar. Okay, derivation tree for string 1 0 1 0 1 1 0. derivation tree start करते वक्त हमारे पास चार production rule है. ये चारों ही production rule हम लोग को use करने हैं. The first production rule every time when we use with the derivation is always the start rule. Here three are start rule. You can use any one from this three, but not this one. Okay? So now let us start with it. I think here I made a miss. No, it is all correct. Okay, so now let us start with this derivation tree. We want the first string to be, first symbol in the string to be 1. So we will focus on the production rule which gives us the first symbol as 1. And now we understood this will fit best. So what will I do? I'll start with the start state as I told you. And I'll go with this particular production. It is giving 1s. Okay, next. After 1, I want 0. After 1, I want 0. So 0 1 दे रहा है. A देगा तो A बाद में finish हो रहा है, stop हो रहा है. लेकिन मुझे continue करना है. If I want to continue, I will go with the repeating loop, that is S. So मैं क्या use करूँगी? 0 S. Okay. Now after this 0, I want 1. So 1 चाहिए तो मैं 1 S use करूँगी. After this 1, I want 0. तो ये 0 मुझे repeating वाला चाहिए, इसलिए मैं first rule use कर रही हूँ. After this 1 0 1 0, I want 1 1 0. फिर मुझे 1 चाहिए, I'll go with 1s. Next again I want 1, I'll go with 1s. Now I want last 0 and then I want to stop. If I go with this, I'll have to continue. So I'll go with this one, third rule. Okay, what is it? 0 and A. Okay, and finally A goes to epsilon. So here we are done with the derivation tree. It has stopped also and it has given us the string that we wanted. So if we just traverse the string in this direction and try to read the string, that is 1 0 1 0 1 1 0, which is the correct string. Okay, so when you're drawing in, when you're writing in exam, you need not to show these arrows with the direction, but you just need to make a final statement that the string derived is this. Okay, this we have done derivation with respect to the right linear grammar. Similarly, left linear grammar ka bhi derivation tree dekhte hai. Okay, so we'll see derivation tree for left linear grammar, again for the same string, 1 0 1 0 1 1 0, because they have asked derivation tree for both the grammars. Okay, again we'll start with the start state, lekin yahan pe to start state ek hi hai, so we'll start with S. Of course we'll go with the one first rule, because this is the only rule which we have to start with. Okay, now what is it saying? It will always consider the ending with. Here hum log ne starting with consider kiya tha, yahan pe hum log ending with consider karenge. क्यों? बिकॉज ये लेफ्ट लीनियर ग्रामर है और इसके कैपिटल लेटर हमेशा लेफ्ट में होते हैं, तो ये लेफ्ट से प्रोग्रेस करेगा, राइट से नहीं करेगा. ओके, सो दैट इज क्लियर. नाउ नाउ वी हैव गॉट द लास्ट जीरो. आफ्टर दिस लास्ट जीरो व्हाट डू वी वांट? वन. वन चाहिए तो मुझे कौन सा रूल लेना पड़ेगा? ऑफकोर्स ये वाला, थर्ड वाला. सो आई विल गो विद ए वन. नाउ आफ्टर दिस वन आई वॉन्ट टू रीड वन मोर टाइम वन, सो आई विल गो विद द सेम रूल. After this one, I want to read 0. So I'll go with the second rule. After this 0, I want to read 1. I'll go with the third rule. And after this 1, I want to read 0. So I'll go with the second rule. Okay. After this, I want to read 1 and I want to stop. But lekin A ke pass 1 read karke stop par hone wala koi rule hi nahi hai. There is only one rule which allows you to read 1, and that is this one. So I'll go with this third rule and I'll read 1. Now I want to stop. I don't want to progress more because my string is finished. So what do I do? If I need to stop, do I have any option? Yes, you have this fourth rule. A giving epsilon which makes you stop. So A giving epsilon which makes you stop. If you start reading this from in order, in order, then this tree, if you read in order, that is we will read it in this direction. That is 1 0 1 0 1 1 0. ओके, एंड विद दिस वी गॉट अ स्ट्रिंग. सो फाइनल स्टेटमेंट आपको लिखना है, वो अगर नहीं लिखा तो आप मार्क्स मिस कर सकते हो. ओके, सो वी विल राइट डाउन द फाइनल स्ट्रिंग अचीव्ड, द फाइनल स्ट्रिंग ऑब्टेन्ड. ओके, इज 1 0 1 0 1 1 0, एंड हियर वी आर डन विद दिस एग्जाम्पल. So I hope you all understood. This is really very easy. Don't miss out this. If you get right linear grammar, left linear grammar, you can solve with the way as I have explained you. But you just need to draw the DFE carefully and properly. Your DFE should be right. If it is wrong, the entire thing is going to be wrong. Okay? So thank you for watching this.